Two seasons ago, we saw the emergence of Valtteri 2.0. An impressive start to the season saw him take 2 wins and 3 pole positions as he went blow for blow with his teammates. The next 5 races were relatively mediocre in comparison. However, he still took 4 podiums within that stretch. 2 poor weekends in Germany and Hungary meant that going into the summer break, he had a 62-point deficit to Hamilton. From there, both the Ferraris and Red Bulls became more competitive and wins became a lot harder to come by. Nevertheless, he was still able to win 2 races in Suzuka and Austin to cap off what was, and still is, the best year of his career to date. Fast forward to the 2020 season, and Bottas had another flying start, taking pole by just a single 1/100 of a second and winning the 8th race of his career. But that one race was about as good as it was gonna get. From then on, Hamilton was faultless in his performances, only experiencing 2 minor slip-ups in Monza and Sochi en route to a record-equaling 7th World Championship. Did Bottas do anything wrong? Is his seat under threat? Be sure to stick around until the end to find out what's at stake for Valtteri Bottas. Before we dive into it, I just want to remind you guys watching to drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel with bell notifications to keep up to date with the latest Formula 1 content. Also, if you've been around here a while and you like what you see, be sure to share this video around with others who you think might enjoy it. But anyway, now we've got that out of the way, let's get into it. Firstly, let's talk about Valtteri's qualifying. In 2019, Bottas's average deficit to Hamilton was just over 1/10 of a second, and the head-to-head score was 7-14. In comparison to 2020, his average deficit to Hamilton actually decreased to 0.08 of a second, with the head-to-head score being 4-12. Lewis, quite simply, was able to pull the lap out of the bag in crunch time, a trademark trait of his that has led him to 98 career pole positions. Valtteri, albeit much closer in terms of average gap, was dominated by his teammates on a Saturday. This shouldn't come as a surprise though, given that at the end of 2019, Lewis said that he wasn't fully on top of his game in qualifying, therefore, he made sure to perfect it for 2020. Valtteri's undoing mainly came on a Sunday. His starts, for some reason, were substandard not only compared to his teammates, but other drivers around him. In Hungary, he had a jump start. In Spain, Monza, Bahrain and Sakhir, he was jumped by midfield drivers and a new teammate who barely knew how to operate the W11. And then, there was Turkey.
Oh my God.
Overall, across those 6 races, Bottas lost a total of 26 places, with 11 of those coming at the Turkish Grand Prix. This then left him struggling to battle his way back to the front, which would in turn limit his options on strategy. It's what allowed Max Verstappen to seize his opportunity for a P2 finish on numerous occasions, even with an inferior car. While we're on the topic of Verstappen, we might as well talk about his poor reliability and how it affected his chances of finishing P2 in the championship. Over the course of the season, Max failed to finish a race on 5 occasions. His percentage of laps completed was the lowest of any other driver on the grid at 77%. On the other hand, Valtteri Bottas had just the 1 retirement and completed 96% of all laps in 2020. Statistically, Max's reliability looks abysmal in comparison to Valtteri. However, let's consider each case individually. He lost a potential podium in Austria after an electronic failure. A power unit issue in Monza forced him into retirement on lap 30, however, at that point, he was running down in P14, so no points were lost there. In Mugello, another engine issue prevented him from jumping the 2 Mercedes, and eventually, he ended up tangling with Gasly, Raikkonen and Grosjean in what could have been another podium. A puncture in Imola cost him another P2, and the retirement in Sakhir was merely the misfortune of being in the wrong place at the wrong time. In comparison, Bottas had a puncture at the first Silverstone race and lost a P2 in Germany after a power unit failure. Both drivers lost a potential 36 points due to a puncture and an engine failure. So, the only other mechanically related retirement Verstappen had over Bottas was Mugello, and it's difficult to say where he would have finished given how early he retired. Therefore, to say Verstappen would have beaten Bottas had it not been for reliability is not 100% guaranteed. Bottas did have fewer retirements, but they were also very costly. Now, with what should be a better all-around package for this season, Verstappen will be looking to pick up where he left off in 2020 and bring the strongest challenge possible to the Mercs. Alongside him is the man who shocked the world with his last-to-first victory, Sergio Perez. The Red Bull driver lineup is as strong as it has ever been. Therefore, Bottas will need to be on top of his game. It'll be especially important for him to improve his starts, as a minimum of P3 will not be guaranteed with Checo around. Race days will now only get even tougher, as both Red Bulls will be there to capitalise. Alongside the pressure to beat the Red Bulls will be the pressure to perform against arguably the greatest driver of all time. Right now, Valtteri has the toughest job in Formula 1. We've seen that on the occasions where he does manage to win, it takes an absolutely immaculate weekend with zero errors and faultless driving. Even then, he'll still need Hamilton to have some kind of bad luck in order to get anywhere near his level. And on the days where Lewis is on top of everything, the competition might as well not even show up. Over the years, Hamilton has worked on executing the perfect weekend on a more consistent basis. The man is suffocatingly consistent, to the point where Valtteri doesn't even know how to respond in the post-race press conferences.
Yeah, and obviously some cars behind with a soft tire, they had the upper hand, but you know, I was pretty pleased that I could get the lead, but to be honest, after that, I just had no pace today. I don't understand why, but no pace.
When you're being beaten like that, race after race after race, it completely destroys your confidence, and you even start driving below your own capabilities, which is exactly what happened going into the Sakhir Grand Prix. By that point, Valtteri was already a broken man, and in comes a hungry 22-year-old George Russell with absolutely nothing to lose. No matter what, there was no winning outcome in this situation. The worst case scenario would be if he was outshined by his less experienced teammate, which is exactly what's happened, bringing us to this present moment in time where Valtteri is up against it to perform. With rising competition comes rising expectation, and Bottas will be expected to push Hamilton as hard as possible, whilst also playing the supportive role he's been doing for the last 4 years. Having been outperformed by Russell in the same car, he will somehow need to show Mercedes that he's worth keeping for the future. One positive he has going for him is that he doesn't create internal conflicts. One of the main reasons Mercedes has such a harmonious working environment is due to Valtteri's presence. He's a very transparent, no BS character who is willing to do what's in the best interests of the team. Having another driver come in and shift that balance is something Mercedes don't want, especially given other teams will most likely be a lot closer in 2022. Having said that, George Russell is the future, and keeping him in a Williams for another however many years is only going to hinder his progress. He's also very professional in his demeanor and approach, therefore Mercedes might be able to accommodate him alongside Lewis without the two falling out internally. My only concern with this is George potentially experiencing the same fate as Bottas, or even more so, a guy like Stoffel Vandoorne, who had the greatest single season in GP2 history. But even then, he couldn't get close to a prime Fernando Alonso in the same car. Now yes, the two situations are not directly comparable. Vandoorne was entering McLaren when they were a hot mess, whereas Russell would be entering a much stabler environment in Mercedes. However, going up against any veteran driver is always going to be a challenge. Going up against a world champion with almost no weaknesses in their game is potentially career-ending. Regardless, Bottas is under pressure this year, and a lot of it. The onus will be on him to ensure that his starts are as good as possible, and he is more consistent in delivering P2s for Mercedes when he's not in a position to win. Otherwise, if he has another 2018-type season, his time at Mercedes could very well come to an end. This is a story that I think will be very intriguing as the season progresses, so be sure to keep an eye out for future videos from your boy Ben by subscribing to the channel and hitting the bell icon so you don't miss out. If you found this informative, be sure to drop it a like and share it around with others who you think will enjoy it too. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.